The EP Podcast. Heard everywhere podcasts can be found. And always at theeppodcast.com.
And welcome into the EP Podcast. My name is Chris Lanuti. Welcome to the weekend update coming out each and every Friday to give you a very quick look at everything going on in and around Evergreen Park. Plus, we'll get you prepared for our regular Monday 30 Minutes of Good on demand when you wake up right after this weekend ends. We will get you started on the right foot. All of it is brought to you by the First National Bank of Evergreen Park. It's back to school time, and no matter what that looks like this year, the First National Bank of Evergreen Park can set students up for success with a student checking account. Whether they are starting their first job or heading off to college, students will have the resources they need to manage their money from anywhere with online and mobile banking tools like remote check deposit, cardless cash, and more. Plus, no minimum required to open. Visit bankevergreenpark.com/student checking. Get started today. Member FDIC. Fall is upon us. Let's talk about the weather coming to the EP now. All hope that I had of keeping the pool open for an extra weekend ended today. I've actually already started draining it. I act like I have a big pool. It's one of those Walmart specials. I hope it just survives to next year. My reasoning? It is not going to be as warm as originally thought this weekend. 68 the day this show comes out on Friday, September the 11th. A 73 high on Saturday the 12th. But at the highest temperatures, there's going to be thunderstorms. Mostly in the 60s all day, raining for pretty much the entire day on Saturday. There goes my projects. I don't know how they're doing the Most Holy Redeemer barbecue bash. Luckily, they're all doing it at home, so maybe they'll just move that to Sunday, because luckily on Sunday, there should be a very little chance of rain. Partly cloudy the entire day. That's going to be your best day of the weekend, 75. The sun comes out. It will warm up a little bit next week, mainly by midweek. But get ready for board games with the kids this Saturday. That may be bad news for our only garage sale going on in Evergreen Park this weekend. A one-day only sale at 2904 West 101st Place on Saturday, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Bring an umbrella to that one. Looking for something for your kids to do in a safe way, Evergreen Park High School and the EP Recreation Department partnering up for a girls boys instructional basketball league. New high school head basketball coach Jim Sexton is going to be leading this. Program is also going to feature appearances by the varsity basketball players. All this will take place at the new Evergreen Park High School Sportsplex at 2700 West 91st Street. That's the old racket and tennis club. It starts on the 20th of September, so it's coming up. It's $65, it's 8 weeks long, and it ends in November. Register at the Evergreen Park Community Center, 3450 West 97th Street. There's also going to be indoor cycling at the community center. If you want to register for that, COG Fitness 11, COG Fitness 11 at gmail.com. Send an email, get more info. Also, be aware if you have a kid in District 124, they're partnering up with Culver's and they're doing their fundraiser beginning on Monday, this Monday. Donate while you dine just by ordering your Culver's favorites. And do not forget your vehicle stickers, because the deadline is Tuesday. This Tuesday, the 15th. Remember, you can do it online. I want to send some congratulations out to a former teacher of mine who just got the job as the new principal of Queen of Martyrs. Congrats to Doc Mathias, a man whose head I once shaved for charity when I was a sophomore in high school at Brother Ice. It looks like most of that came back, Doc. Good for you. He was a great teacher. He's going to be a great principal over there. The Chamber of Commerce wants you to know Chamber of Commerce Week is this upcoming week, the 14th through the 18th. A small business marketing series is going to kick off on Wednesday, the 16th, with a noon Zoom session on LinkedIn marketing. That series will continue each and every week for several weeks. At some point, I believe on the 7th of October, I'm hosting one. Meanwhile, on the 17th, virtual bingo. Free to participate, prizes given, gift cards from chamber members. Anybody can participate. It'll be happening during the EP Podcast Live, which starts at 7 p.m. every Thursday night. You don't need to listen to the EP Podcast to play, but if you want to put us on in the background, we're going to be playing along with you during the live show. And right now, you can purchase apparel from the exclusive EPCC Apparel Store. This virtual store is open until the 27th of September, and all proceeds from the sale will be given to businesses of your choice. Check out evergreenparkchamber.org for more details. The president of the Evergreen Park Chamber of Commerce was on the live show just this past Thursday. You're going to hear her on Monday's On Demand episode. A peek into that interview and details about what's coming up on Monday right after this. Nancy's Home Care is a veteran-owned home care agency servicing those in and around Evergreen Park. They're also a certified dementia care trainer. If your goal is to keep your loved ones in the safety and comfort of home for as long as possible, you want to contact Nancy's Home Care now. Nancy's Home Care specializes in helping clients with Alzheimer's, dementia, cancer, stroke, and fall injuries. They provide companion care services such as meal preparation, cognitive stimulation, light housekeeping, and medication reminders. Their personal care services consist of help with bathing, dressing, grooming, ambulatory assistance. Contact them today, 773-966-3003. They're right here in your own backyard, Evergreen Park, 773-966-3003, or visit nancyshomecare.com. Coming up this Monday on the EP Podcast, the 30 Minutes of Good in a World of Dumb on demand when you wake up each and every Monday, brought to you by the First National Bank of Evergreen Park. Dr. David Beckman is going to join us for a little bit of a game show we're going to have. We're going to have a little bit of fun with COVID, if we can. Our local Evergreen Park doctor, who's been on the show so much, will share his struggle with COVID-19, the symptoms, how long they lasted, the after effects, and also why he still thinks you should not panic, just be careful when it comes to this disease. On top of that, we're going to visit with Laura Freeman, the president of the Evergreen Park Chamber of Commerce, during Chamber of Commerce Week. She'll be joined by Bill Byrus. They're both working for Berkshire Hathaway, Byrus Real Estate. And we're going to talk about real estate in Evergreen Park. Now, you might think to yourself, how can this be interesting? Turns out, COVID-19 has changed all the rules when it comes to real estate. Here's a quick sneak peek.
You have three phases in a year. Your first phase or first rush of buyers comes out in the spring. They want to be settled. They want a new home by the time summer starts. Your next wave of buyers comes out in the summer. They want to be settled before school starts. And your last wave of buyers, which is the smallest, comes out in September, October. They want to be settled before the holidays. Right now, all that is off the table. Right now, if a seller is seriously interested in selling, this is the time to do it. Without question, this is the time to do it. We were looking at these numbers earlier, how many homes are available compared to how many are under contract. And that we say 67 under contract, we're saying there's 67 homes that have probably sold within the last 45 days. And there's only 16 left out there right now. This is the time for someone to put it on the market if they are definitely interested in selling. We've never seen anything like this. We've been doing this for 40 years. Never seen anything like this.
Remember to subscribe to the EP Podcast anywhere podcasts can be found, and always you can find it at theeppodcast.com. The guests that I mentioned and much more up ahead this Monday morning on the show. Do not miss it. As we get out of here, I am aware of the fact this show drops on the anniversary, the 19th anniversary of 9/11. And this morning I was thinking about it and realized that years and years later, I always come back to the same memories. Everybody's experience was different, but at the time I was a young guy in his 20s at my second radio station, WOMP Womp FM in Wheeling, West Virginia, just outside of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And my show ended right around 9 o'clock Eastern time. And we had a late thing that we were doing, so I pushed all the commercials back and started them about 8:55. The guy after me comes in and takes over. The commercials are playing. We've had a pretty good show. And I go into this little AM station that's in the building that's playing syndicated AM radio. And they had a TV in there. So I would go in and shut the door, and it was the only place that had a TV in the entire station. And the Today Show's on, and one of the towers is smoking, and they're thinking that maybe a Cessna flew into it. And I remember sitting there going through everything that happened on the show and looking up to the TV and going through what was going on in the show. And then I turned on the sound, and I'm like, wow, that's pretty crazy. That thing's really on fire. And I see a plane right before they cut to something else. There's a plane off in the distance. So in my mind, I'm registering, oh, plane's probably going to do a flyby because there's no way you can see what's going on up there. And then I see the plane come into the picture again. And I'm telling you, right up to the moment until that building exploded, I thought that plane was just flying by to check out the fire. Like the FAA had told them, can you go by and take a look at that big giant building and see what the damage is for the fire department? Like, that's what I thought was happening. And then boom. And I remember I screamed. I remember I walked out into the middle of the office where all these people were working, and I said, we're under attack. And I was like shaking, and they looked at me like I was nuts. And I just kept saying, like, they're flying planes into buildings, jumbo jets into buildings in New York City. Like, I just watched this thing, and I was like, what is that? And nobody believed me. And a couple people followed me into the room, and then they saw the replay, and then they're running around telling everybody else. And it was like panic. And I walked into the radio station where the guy was working, and I said, in between this song and the next song, let me go on. And the song ended, and I told people what was going on real quick and said we'd get him more details. And as I came out of the room, I was asked to go into another room with all the big bosses in the station. And there was a guy by the name of Frank Belli. He oversaw everything that was going on, all these other clusters all around that section of the country for this big company that I was working for. And he asked if I was in the room, and I said, yeah. And he goes, from this point forward, Chris is in charge of the radio station. And I was like in shock. I'm just like the morning guy. Like, I basically had three bosses over me. And they're like, why? And they're like, there's a reason he's there. Not only because of the fact that he does the morning show, but he's the only person with a broadcast journalism degree, and we're not screwing this up. So every single thing that we do from this point forward, until I tell you that this is over, he's in charge. So now my day, which was going to be me going home and taking a nap because I've been up since 4 o'clock in the morning, became me all day at the station. And I was running on pure adrenaline, and I give updates, and I would read all these AP and Reuters reports coming across the wire. And there were so many things going on that people will never know about. There were so many false reports of other planes, other hijackings. The worry was that there were like 10 or 15 planes up there, and they were all hijacked. And there was even one that was heading towards Chicago, which made me nervous because I was from Chicago. And later they found out the guy had like a bad transmitter and wasn't responding because of some issue on the plane. But it was a suspected hijacking for a while. And I'm reading all these things on these reports, and I call my dad up. And he's been watching this on TV, and he's over at 18th and State. And he works for the Chicago Police Department. He's a commander. And I remember I'm talking to him about what I'm seeing, and I'm like, I don't know if this is confirmed, but this is stuff that hasn't come out in the press yet, just so you know. And an alarm goes off. And in the background, you heard his voice come over a loudspeaker at the police station at 18th and State, and it says, all personnel scramble immediately to the Sears Tower. And it kept saying, this is not a drill. It was like something out of a movie. And he's on the phone with me, and he goes, I can't get a hold of your mother or your sister, and I'm watching this thing on TV, and this doesn't look very good, what's going on in New York. And if it happens here, it's going to be bad here too. Tell him I love him. Now, nothing happened in Chicago. He didn't run in any burning building, but I'm on the phone. I'm like, you don't need to go. You're a commander. Take your time. He goes, no, I'm going. And he just hung up the phone. And I sat there in shock watching all this stuff. And then I go out on top of a mountain there, because the radio station was on a mountain. And I'm looking around right around the time that they were trying to figure out where Flight 93 was. And there's nothing in the sky. And off of the distance, because I'm right there. I mean, it was right nearby where that plane went down. I saw that plane. And I keep thinking to myself years later, like, that was probably around the time they were thinking about making their move. And here I am standing on the side of a hill in West Virginia looking towards the Pennsylvania side in southwest Pennsylvania. And I'll tell you one thing. There were no Jets following it. I always laugh at that conspiracy theory. I watched it. They weren't there. I knew where to look because I had been reading all the AP reports and I was getting all this stuff, so I went out to go see if I could see it. Plus, I needed to clear my head after hearing my father say that and hanging up the phone on me. And that's what I remember that day. But the most important thing I remember is the fact that he was going. And all the guys and gals, all the people that ran towards the burning buildings, that's what I try to remember on this day. You know, this is a crappy time in this country. And I think we all know that, and I think it's very easy for us to get angry about different things, but we have to remember that those people still exist. And that's why I try to remember that during 9/11. Because there are still really good people out there who are going to run towards those buildings. I want everybody to have a great weekend. I can't wait to see you on Monday. We're going to have a great time with Dr. Beckman. We did this whole game show on Thursday night on the live show. I'm going to air it during the on-demand show. I can't wait to share what happened in Evergreen Park with all the real estate during COVID. It's such a fascinating conversation. So much ahead on Monday. Have a great weekend. Stay dry. Good luck to the barbecue bashers. And we will see you soon on the EP Podcast, found everywhere podcasts can be found, and always at theeppodcast.com.
Look at all those people in this great suburb driving down 95th and Kedzie. What a great place. It's called Evergreen Park, but we know it better as the EP. We're known for more than just the Unabomber. Remember Ted Kaczynski? You guys might even remember that big old rooster on 95th Street. It's all part of EP's history. So listen up to the EP Podcast. You might be asking why. Because we talk about all things and we celebrate all the great things in the 608-05. It's the EP Podcast. All things Evergreen Park. It's the EP Podcast. Evergreen Park.